Good afternoon, Ava here. Welcome to the iBug Apple Workshop, episode number 154, for Saturday, September 28th, 2024. Thank you to those joining us in person this afternoon, and to those of you listening to the recorded playback on the iBug Today website, podcast or YouTube channel. The blind community are finding the Apple devices to be useful assistive technology tools in their daily lives. Whether at home, at work or school, or on the go, the accessibility features of the Apple devices have cleared new pathways for the blind to be more productive, consume online content, and stay connected through social media. We have an exciting meeting planned for today. We will first review some iBug announcements and some recent Apple news and rumors. Then, Wes will demo the Samsung SmartThings app, and Herbie will present an overview of the new Apple devices introduced at the Apple event on September 9th. Finally, we will spend any remaining time to answer general questions you may have. I would now like to turn the meeting over to the iBug guy, Michael McCulloch. Ready to go, Michael?
Yes, yes, yes. We are all set to go on a beautiful Saturday afternoon, at least here in Texas, nice and sunny and warm again. Our thoughts and prayers go out to all the people over on the East Coast. I know there was quite a bit of damage over there, so definitely got you guys are in our prayers. Hopefully no one's suffering too much here. Okay, well, we've got a big meeting planned this afternoon, as Ava said, and I too want to just welcome everyone here. First thing we're going to do is go around the room and have everyone introduce themselves. And so, Julie, if you can set it up where people can unmute themselves. And as you introduce yourself, what we want to know is your name, where you're connecting in from. And also, we have a little icebreaker. And we're interested in what's your favorite morning drink? Coffee, tea, or something else? So who'd like to get it kicked off?
Misty from New Jersey. And my favorite drink in the morning is Slim Fast.
Slim? Herbie in Houston, coffee.
All right. Welcome, Misty, Herbie.
Robert in Chandler, Arizona, herbal tea.
All right. Welcome, Robert.
Pat in Ohio, tea.
Okay.
Ted, Valerie from Southern California, green tea.
Welcome, Valerie.
Ted in Houston and hot coffee, large.
Jackie Boomstra in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and I like coffee in the morning.
All right. Welcome, Jackie.
Very Williamson, iced tea.
Oh, iced tea. All right.
Glenn in Kingston, New York, coffee.
Welcome, Glenn.
Helene in Woodstock, New York. And I start the day with warm lemon water with a pinch of cayenne.
Ooh. Spicy girl. Mm-hmm. All right. Who else we got out there?
Desi in Franklin, Tennessee. And I cannot start a day without my coffee.
All right. I'm there with you.
Paul in Columbus, coffee.
Welcome, Paul.
Who else are you from?
Go ahead. Who's that? The lady.
This is Dee from Southern Illinois.
Hey, Dee. What's your favorite drink in the morning?
Favorite drink in the morning? Water.
All right.
Gloria from Houston. Herbal tea.
Okay, welcome, Dylan.
Dan from Southern California, coffee.
All right, Dan. And anybody joining us after we're just going around introducing ourselves, name, where you're from, and what's your favorite drink in the morning?
John BC.
No, go ahead.
John BC, Canada, and orange juice.
Oh, okay. Very good. All right, Jody's up.
And Jody in New Hampshire. Gotta be coffee.
Gotta be coffee. Very good.
Wes in Houston, coffee.
All right. Looks like the coffee drinkers are coming in strong here. Anybody else that can get a chance to introduce themselves?
This is Roy in Texas, and I like iced tea with the squirt of lemon.
Wow. Okay. Two iced teas in the morning. Anybody else? Name where you're calling from and what's your favorite beverage?
Cynthia, Houston, coffee with soy milk.
All right. Very good. Just remember, once you've introduced yourself, if you can go ahead and mute yourself, that'd be cool. Anyone else that didn't get a chance to introduce themselves, here's your chance.
Bridget from Atlanta Coffee.
All right. I don't know if anybody's keeping count. I think the coffee drinkers are a little bit in the lead.
Yeah, a lot of coffee out there.
Anybody else? Okay, well, we'll have a chance later on for those that come in after our base intro here. I guess I'll go ahead and go. This is Michael in Texas. And I start out with a big 16-ounce glass of water, followed by coffee. Okay, well, thanks, everybody, for doing that. Let's see. We want to acknowledge any of our first-time guests here. Anybody here for the first time at the Apple Workshop?
Cynthia, first time.
Oh, Cynthia. Let's see. Tell me again where you're from.
Houston.
Oh, that's right. You're in Houston. Okay. And I know you've been on some other of our training sessions. Tell me what devices, Apple devices, do you use?
I just got an iPad Air, so I'm listening to you on iPad Air, and then I have an iPhone 15 Pro and a iPhone 7 Max or Plus.
Oh, wow. Okay. You got some nice devices there. Very good. Any other first timers? Okay, well, very good. And let's see. Next, we're going to acknowledge anyone that had a birthday in September. Any September birthdays out there?
This is Jackie, and my birthday was September 5.
All right. Well, happy belated birthday, Jackie.
Thank you.
This is Dee. On the 19th.
Ms. D.
Amazing.
Big. That was the big one, huh? 40?
Where did you get that idea?
happy,
it was 23.
Happy birthday, D.
Thank you.
Anybody else? September birthdays. I don't think she's here. But I know one of our people that she actually is our coordinator for our mentoring program, our Jumpstart mentoring program, Terry Ann, had a birthday this past week. So we'll say happy birthday to her. Anybody else with a birthday in September?
Michael, can you hear me?
I do. Inti.
Yes, I'm sorry. I was having a hard time unmuting. That's why I couldn't speak. So this is Inti from Iowa, and I have to say, I guess I'm not doing the birthday. I'm doing my favorite drink,
okay,
which is I usually have water and then hot coffee with cream.
Oh, look at there. You are almost just like me, except for the cream. I just do mine black.
Mm-hmm. My husband's sitting right here, and he said, and whiskey. But he's just lying.
Well, you can put a few shots of whiskey in there. That's okay. All right. Very good.
Thanks.
Welcome, Inti. All right. One more chance. Any more birthdays? Okay. We are going to move right along. Get into a few iBug announcements. We've got you know, every Monday night coming up this Monday, our iBug Buzz at 7 p.m. Central. All the times I want to give out are actually Central Time, so I don't have to keep repeating that. And they'll all be right here on this same Zoom channel. Then we have Thursday. Next Thursday is Trekkie Talk. First Thursday, it's actually the first and third Thursdays of the month. But on the 3rd, October 3rd, we're going to be pre-watching a couple of episodes of Deep Space Nine. I think they're on episodes 6 and 7. Jody will correct me if I'm not right there. And then they come together that Thursday evening at 8 p.m. to discuss those. And they have a really good, fun meeting there. I've been to several of those. Then next Saturday, on the 5th of October at 8 p.m. also, we are going to have our iBug Unplugged. That's our meeting where we just have topics of a non-technology, technological manner. And this month, the title of that one is called I'm Falling Again. So you can try to figure out what that's going to be about. That'll be Saturday, October 5th. I think because we just turned over into fall season, it probably has something to do with that. All right. And there'll be, you know, email announcements going out about all of these, as well as on our Facebook and other social media to let you know what's going on there. I should probably tell you about the Vela Book Club. That's October the 10th. They're currently reading the book, A Poisonwood Bible, or maybe it's The Poisonwood Bible. The Poisonwood Bible, I guess it is, by Barbara Kingsolver. Wrote another good book that we read recently, which escaped my title. I know it's something to do with not The Magician.
The Conviction.
Was it that one?
The Conviction.
No, you're right.
And it was very good.
Yes. Okay. And this one should be equally as good, The Poisonwood Bible. If you want
it's
to read it.
Africa. It's about
Africa. I finished it. It's so good.
Okay. And let me just throw out the DB number if you're wanting to look for that on BARD NLS. It's DB 46882. 46882. Is the DB number for that. You still have some time since October 10th. Got a little over, not quite 2 weeks to read that. It is kind of a long book, though, I'm thinking. About 19 hours. Then on the 13th of October, the iBug Cafe at 4 p.m. And they are going to be talking about the new iOS 18 software release that came out here this past month. Hopefully, and we'll be seeing how many people have upgraded. And so that'll be a deep dive into some of the cool features of iOS 18. Okay, so that's some of the things coming up. I'm not going to go through the whole month schedule. There'll be a monthly schedule actually coming out on the 1st of October, or maybe the 30th of September. And it'll have everything listed there in detail. Again, all of this also can be found on our website. That is ibugtoday.org, ibugtoday.org, ibugtoday.org. And you can find all the information about upcoming events. Also, if you're not on our mailing list, you can click the tab, the button that says Join iBug, and you can enter your information there and get on our mailing list, and then you will get an email notice of all the upcoming events. Also, you can join our Facebook group. We have a Facebook group that is a good place for information. If you have questions in between all of our different training sessions, you can always post it there. We have people monitoring that all the time and can help get those questions answered for you. Other social media, we've got an Instagram account. You can look for us there. And we're also on X. And our handles there are at iBookToday. Find us. All right. So that's pretty much the iBug announcements. I am now going to switch over and talk about some Apple news and rumors. How much time I got? Oh, it's only 2:15. Okay, we got lots of time. As everybody knows, it was a big Apple event back on September 9th that introduced, you know, the new iPhones, the 16 and 16 Pros, a couple of Apple Watches, getting ready for the new Apple Intelligence AI that Apple is introducing on their devices. There's some upgrades to the AirPods. A new AirPod is coming out, plus an upgrade to the Pro 2s to help out with some hearing issues. So be hearing more about that here later. Herbie's going to be doing providing a good overview of all these different devices. So be sure to stick around for that. Many of you probably heard also on September 9th was the date that AppleViz came back into being after a little hiatus for a couple of months there. Be My Eyes partnered with them and was able to get them back up and running. And so AppleViz, which a lot of us use as a resource, is now back and doing their thing with different reviews. And they've got a podcast you can subscribe to, a lot of good information there. Be My Eyes was also in the news. You probably maybe heard that they've partnered with Meta, Facebook, the old Facebook, the Meta Ray-Ban smart glasses. And so that's going to be a great feature to have access to a Be My Eyes agent and be hands-free with wearing those Ray-Ban glasses. We're probably going to be doing a deep dive in one of the cafes coming up here in the next couple of months on the Meta Ray-Ban, so be sure to watch out for that. What else we got? There was some news about possibly some new iPad coming out. Maybe, I don't know, next month there's going to be an event in October, maybe, rumor has it, to introduce some new iPads, maybe some upgrades to Macs. I can't remember. Somebody just got a new iPad Air, so I don't know if they're going to upgrade the iPad Air or not, but I think they're for sure going to upgrade the basic iPad 10 and probably go to an iPad 11. Hopefully it'll have the Apple Intelligence features if they will put in the A17 or 18 chip in it. What else? We've got, Apple has a smart home accessibility or accessory, I guess. Mark Gurman from, I forgot what magazine he writes for now, but anyway, he introduced or mentioned that there was this new device. It's kind of an combination iPad, maybe HomePod, Apple TV, and to distinguish it from the rectangular type iPad, it's more thought to be more of a square-shaped device, handheld device that can be used to control, if you've got the HomeKit, any Apple HomeKit devices, or if you got any Matter devices, then they could all be controlled from this one source. Okay, let's see. Well, we're going to talk about the new AirPods too, but there was a firmware update just a few days ago. And you don't really have any control over that. Just once you plug in your AirPods on an AC power charger, then it will update that firmware. And so you can always check in your settings. It would be the build number is 7A305. There was another firmware update just earlier in the month of September, and that was 7A302. So if you have 7A302, then you know you're still on the old build. But speculation is the 305 is the one that's going to allow the hearing support. So that'll be pretty cool. If anybody's in the market for iPad Pros, there was some news about Best Buy really coming down on the price, dropping the price by $1,000 on some M2 iPad Pros, both the 10.9 and the 11.9. Yeah, is that right? Yeah, 11-inch and 13-inch, 12.9 iPad Pros. So if you're in the market for those devices. Oh, Apple TV Plus. Probably some of you know Apple TV Plus several years ago bought the rights to the Peanuts series. And so over the last couple of years, anyway, they've been providing the holiday versions of the Peanuts free to anyone, usually a couple of days a week or a couple of days out of the month. And so the one for around Halloween time, fall, it's the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown, I think is supposed to be out October 19th and 20th. You can watch those without having a subscription to Apple TV Plus. And then around Thanksgiving, a Charlie Brown Thanksgiving is supposed to be out November 23rd and 24th. And then finally, a Charlie Brown Christmas out December 14th and 15th. So take advantage of that if you want to watch those and don't have a subscription. But of course, if you have an Apple TV subscription, you can watch those at any time. Even though the iPhone 16 just came out, there are already rumors out about the iPhone 17. And I'm going to post in our Facebook group a link to 10 reasons to wait for the new year, wait another year for the iPhone 17. If you haven't got the 16 yet, it's given 10 reasons to wait another year. Let's see. I'm going to end our discussion here about Julia. Is everybody on mute right now?
Yes.
Okay, good. All right. I'm going to play something here. Some of you may have seen this from the Tonight Show, Jimmy Fallon. Well, let's see if I can get this up and going.
Well, guys, as sure as a lot of you know, the iPhone 16 came out this past Friday. And, of course, I was first in line to get it. Literally, I was up at the Apple Store on Fifth Avenue having a great time with everybody. I ended up being having a surprise run-in with someone who you might.
I'm going to pause there just a second. Someone told me, when Jimmy Fallon's there at the Apple Store on Fifth Avenue, and he's actually wearing the Vision Pro goggles, glasses. So just to give you some context.
Recognize. Take a look.
Hi, everyone. I'm here at the Apple Store on Fifth Avenue to get my brand new iPhone 16. I'm super psyched, and I just got a message that they're bringing it to me right now.
Here you go, Jimmy.
Oh, my goodness. It's Tim Cook. It makes it look like Tim Cook is giving you the iPhone. It's amazing. Oh, my gosh. It feels like Tim Cook. This is awesome.
Jimmy, it is me, Tim Cook.
Oh, my God. Sorry. Hi.
How are you? Take a walk with me?
I'm going
to the Upper East Side store.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Do you do this thing every launch? Do you go to all the Apple stores?
Every launch, I try to come to Fifth Avenue.
because it's sort of the center of the world, and the enthusiasm is so incredible there.
Do you feel like a rock star? I mean, everyone's like screaming, they're loving you. It's like
it's an out of body experience. I just remind myself that their love is for Apple, and I just happen to be the person that they attribute it to.
How long have you worked at Apple?
27 years. Yeah.
Did you have any idea that you were going to run Apple?
To be CEO? No. No clue at all.
No, even
no. Hint. No. No. No.
Were you Timmy Cook back then?
Maybe TC, but not Timmy Cook.
Were you always into computers and tech and growing up?
I started in college in Auburn, and in very intrigued by computers and the productivity that they could yield and the creativity that they could bring out.
I was a computer science major.
Oh, you are?
Yeah,
that's
a little
crazy.
Bit. Until it got
that's
really
crazy.
Hard. But I know COBOL. I know C++ a little bit. I made a program once to return videotapes.
Really?
Talk about a bad investment.
Oh, my God.
So this is the new iPhone right here.
It's the new iPhone. It's incredible.
What are you most excited about?
I'm excited about all of it, to be honest with you. Apple Intelligence is coming next month, and so it comes in October. It'll start with things like summarization of your emails, which is huge for me because I get hundreds a day. And, you know, one little click, and all of a sudden it summarized this long email.
Really?
Yeah. You can do Genmoji. You can do Image Playgrounds. Lots of really things that you do every day.
Do you walk around New York a lot when you're here?
I do. I love walking around New York.
When you go to the Central Park, do you get a hot dog or anything?
Oh, sometimes I will.
Before you tell me what you get on your hot dog, I have a psychic ability, and I can tell if people like ketchup or mustard.
Oh, what do you say?
It takes a lot of energy from me. Look at me. You're interesting. Feeling. Gosh, I hope I'm right. Mustard.
You're right.
That's good.
I didn't know that.
Really good. I don't know why. You want mustard? Dude, I still got it. Oh my God, I'm drained. I'm mentally drained. I have an idea. Since you're going to your thing, maybe I want to get you some local New York swag.
Oh, wow.
Just so you look like a local when you go in there.
Oh, thank you.
Do you take Apple Pay?
Yeah.
Well, that's good to hear.
Oh, that's a couple of things. Oh, these are good. Yeah, we'll take these. Thanks.
Do locals really wear those?
No, they don't.
Let's
take it off. Yeah, makes sense. Gotcha. We're here.
Here we are.
We're at the Apple store, Upper East, and I'm going to leave you here.
It's so great to spend
thanks
time with you, Jim.
Thanks for the walk
it's
and
so
talk.
So great to talk to
break
you.
Break a leg. Tim Cook, everybody. That was so fun.
Okay, very good. So that was a neat little fun thing there. I don't know if I'm ever in New York at the launch of the iPhones. I'm going to have to go by the Fifth Avenue store. I know we got some people in New York, so hopefully some of you guys can go do that. Let's see, Julie, if you can go ahead and unmute everybody at this time, we'll go ahead and see if anybody has questions on any of the announcements or any other comments, or maybe somebody else has some announcement, Apple-related announcement they'd like to make. All right, you should be able to unmute yourself. Anybody have a question on anything that we've talked about so far in the announcements? Somebody try to unmute, make sure you can unmute.
John from BC, Canada.
Oh, okay. Hey, John.
Hi. I have an iBug question. I was just curious to know if iBug is on Mastodon.
Actually, we are not.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we've thought about it, and we ended up, well, it's a long story.
Oh, that's okay. I mean, I don't use Mastodon. I was just curious.
Yeah, yeah. No, we've looked at it. We just ended up staying on X.
Okay.
And a lot of tech people moved over to Mastodon. I don't know how busy they are these days. I don't know. Anybody using Mastodon? Herbie? I think maybe only one I know of.
Yep, I use Mastodon. And
is it pretty busy, calm?
Well, it's pretty busy. Of course, you know, it's going to depend on how many people you follow and what instance you're on and all that type of thing. But, it's definitely a very active community over there.
Okay. All right, we may have to revisit that then, because I know we're not doing a whole lot on our X account, post things there. I'm not sure how many people we even have following us these days, but... Okay, any other questions? Did anybody happen to see that episode of Tonight Show, Jimmy Fallon? Nobody stays up late enough to watch it, I guess.
This Roy.
Hey, go ahead, Roy.
I had a question about the watch. I didn't hear you mention it, if they had anything new, but I do a lot of exercising, but recently I began falling more often than ever. So my wife thought that a watch might be a good idea for tracking my exercise
And
warning her when I fall. But is there a new iPhone or what's, I mean, iPhone,
the watch. Yeah. We're going to be talking about that here in just a little bit. Herbie's going to be talking about the new watch.
Good. I'll listen.
Yeah.
I'll be here.
All right. Very good. Yep. I use that fall feature quite a bit. There's a couple of interesting stories. All right. Go ahead.
I have a, I don't know if you talked about that because I've been, I'm taking it off and on. Is the AirPods Pro third generation, any talk about coming out or anything like that?
I haven't heard any rumors about the third gen. I know they just made that update to the, you know, AirPods Pro 2, second generation, and which is the one that's going to be able to do the hearing test and can be used as a over-the-counter hearing aid.
So that's the, I mean, I do have the AirPod Pro second generation. I had them for a while, and you're just saying they're going to do something special that's only the feature for the hearing aid?
Yeah, it'll be, there'll probably be some settings that you have to go in and set and to be able to do the hearing test and then to utilize them. Herbie may talk a little bit more about that later, so I don't want to...
Okay, thank you.
His thunder there, if he's going to mention that.
Thank you.
I think Brad may have talked a little bit about it, too, the other night on one of the buzzes. Any other questions? This is your opportunity. Okay, well, we are going to jump right into, we've got a demo by Wes. So, Julie, if you want to go ahead and mute everybody again. Ooh, somebody want to ask a question? All right. So, yeah, Julie, if you can mute everyone again. All right. Okay, I think I stayed unmuted this time. Interesting. All right, let's see. So Wes Farrell is going to tell us a little bit about, well, Wes, if you can come off of mute and just kind of describe your demo a little bit for us. I think you do it some in the demo itself too, but hello, Wes.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, there you are.
All right. Sorry.
No problem.
New headset. So back in 2022, I did a demo of the SmartThings app with the new home appliances we got, as I'll say in the intro. But this is kind of a update to that as far as what new things I've learned about the app and what appliances it will support, like televisions and smart light bulbs. So it's only about 16 minutes. It's pretty short. It was fun making it. And if you like it, I'll make more. Hey, Jimmy's going to do a lot better job than me.
All right. I think I got the right here.
Wow, thing. You make my heart sing. Hello, iBug friends. My name is Wes Farrell, and I am here today to demonstrate some of the features of the Samsung SmartThings app. My last visit with this app demo was in 2022 after we had purchased new appliances for the home. So I demonstrated some of the features of the microwave, dishwasher, stove, refrigerator. Today, I'm going to go back to some of those features to show their accessibility improvements, such as the microwave, and I have a few new things to share. For those of you who do not remember, let me give a brief overview of the app. The Samsung SmartThings app is, of course, created to manage Samsung devices, but you can manage other devices as well, such as Ring doorbells or thermostats. So it's pretty versatile in the things it will do, and although everything is not accessible, Samsung does a pretty good job with their accessibility features. Okay, we are in the kitchen, and I'm going to demonstrate a feature of the microwave, which they fixed in a update that allows you to do the presets to the microwave, such as if you want to cook pizza or reheat. So here we go. I am on the device tab, and I have the microwave selected.
Microwave, ready. Double tap to microwave. Smart things. Navigate up. Button. Double tap to activate. Microwave home. More options. Button. Selected. Microwave. Hood. Tattoo of two. Comma. Microwave.
Don't worry, we're going to go over the hood as well.
100%. 0 minutes. 30 seconds. You can set up settings below and send it to your microwave. Then, press the button on your microwave to activate the settings.
So you noticed above it had where you can give it a time and a percentage of power. So if you want to do your own settings, you can certainly do that, but I like these presets here.
Send to microwave button, double tap to activate.
Send to microwave sends a preset to the microwave.
Mode microwave, double tap
and
to activate.
Mode by default is set to microwave. I'm not sure exactly what that one does, but I'm going to double tap it so we can change it.
Not checked. Frozen entree. Heat frozen entree quickly and easily. Radio button. Double tap to activate.
So it does have presets here, and it doesn't always put you at the top.
Select mode.
So if you tap at the top, it'll say select mode, and then you can make sure you're up there.
Checked. Microwave. Heat food quickly and easily. Radio. Not checked. Popcorn. Heat popcorn quickly and easily. Not checked. Potato. Heat potato quickly and easily. Not checked. Pizza. Heat pizza quickly and easily. Radio button. Double tap to activate.
So we're going to do pizza.
Check. Selected.
I double tap that. And the easiest way to get to the bottom is to just three-finger swipe up until you get
not
to
checked.
The
Veggies.
Very bottom.
Selected. Not checked. Reheat. Not checked. Not checked. Not checked. Not checked. Not checked. Not checked. Cancel. Apply.
Okay, so we're going to apply pizza.
Serve. Selected. Mode. Pizza. Double tap to activate. Off. Filter reminder. Mode. Send to microwave. Button. Double tap to activate.
So, I just swiped up to get to send to microwave, and when you hit send to microwave...
Send to microwave. Button. Send this recipe to the microwave.
It beeped, and then...
Send this recipe to the microwave. Press the button on the micro... Okay. Button. Double tap to activate.
So, what it's asking me to do is press the start button on the microwave to start it. If you send anything to any Samsung device, you have to hit the start button on the device. So I have a bump dot on it, and I have a bump dot on a few other things like cancel.
Okay, the comma.
So I'm at the microwave, I'm finding my bump dot, and come on. There we go.
Sensing. Ellipsis.
So it's cooking non-existent pizza right now. So I'm going to cancel that, but one thing it does is the SmartThings app will send a notification to your phone when the pizza is done, which is pretty nice. There.
Paused.
Actually, paused it, didn't cancel it, but that's another nice thing you can do is pause. And when you go up in your device list or your your favorites for microwave,
navigate up, button, double, location information, button, refrigerator, smart, dishwasher, no room is, Carol, but refrigerator, dishwasher, microwave, paused.
It actually tells you that the microwave is paused. That's one thing with the device tab that is an issue right now is your voiceover tends to jump all over the place. So I'm going to go back into the microwave to show you something else that they fixed, which is the hood, which has the fan and the light under the microwave.
Microwave, paused. Refrigerator, dishwasher, microwave, paused. Double tap, microwave, pot, stove, kitchen, stove, stove. Microwave, paused. Microwave, navigate
there we
off,
go.
Button, double tap, microwave home, more options, selected, microwave, hood, tattoo of two, double
so
tap.
So I'm activate. Going to double tap on hood.
Selected, hood, tattoo, button, double tap to activate. Wind strength, boost, double tap to activate. Off, cooktop light, wind strength, button, double tap to, wind strength, off, cooked button, double tap to, selected, device control. Service, tap, select, button, off, wind strength, button, double tap to, wind strength, boost, double tap to activate, dim, off, cooktop light, switch, double
okay,
tap to activate.
This is for the cooktop light, and you can turn that off or on. It's off right now.
On, cooktop.
It's on.
Switch, double tap
and
to activate.
And that's kind of a good one. I have some vision, but if you're total, that's really a nice feature, especially if you're near someone else and you want to know if the light's off or not.
Off, cooktop, wind strength, boost, double tap to activate, dim, wind strength, but not checked, low, not checked, not checked, not checked, high, double tap to activate.
So I went to the wind strength, which is for the fan on the hood, and I'm going to change it to high so we can hear it.
Not checked. Hi. Double tap to activate.
There we go.
Tap to activate. Selected. Device.
And I had to walk away to turn that thing off because I could not hear my voiceover. So, yeah, that's a strong fan.
Pause. Button. Double button. Double tap to activate. Button. Double tap to activate. Available devices. Automatically find cook. Scan. Automatically find cooktops that can be. Auto connectivity. Button. Double tap to activate. Auto connectivity. Navigate up. Navigate auto connect. Scan. Automatically find available devices. Button. Double tap to activate. Button. Auto scan. Auto connectivity. Navigate up. Navigate up. Button. Navigate up. Button. Double tap to button. Double wind strength. High. Double tap off. Cooktop light. Wind strength. Button. Double tap. Wind strength. High. Wind strength. Not check. Low. Not check. Medium. Check. Not check. Boost. Double tap to not check. Check. Not check. Low. Double tap, not check, low, not check, not check, boost, double tap to activate, not check, low, not check, medium, double check, high, double tap, not check, boost, double tap to activate, not check, boost, button, double, selected, good, tattoo 2, microwave, tap 1, selected, button, double tap to activate, wind strength, boost, button, double tap to activate, button, double tap to activate.
All right, so now we are going to do a quick demo of a smart light bulb. This is one in the kitchen, and it's just a smart light bulb, no fan attached.
Smart bulb SL20, off. Double tap
so
to view details.
Currently it's off, and one nice thing about this, you can
button
turn it on by swiping to the right, and that button will allow you to turn it on without having to go into the device.
Dim. Button. Smart bulb SL20, on.
So
double tap to view details.
The light is on, but if you want to go into the device,
smart bulb SL20, smart things, 3000.
All these functions.
Cap K, 3000, 18, switch button, off. 3000, 18.6%, adjust, switch button, off, selected, controls, tab, routines, tab, history, tab,
but
color temperature, 3000, cap K. 3008, switch button, off.
So it has all these
double
things, and I'm not even sure what they are. It's something to do with the light warmth. It's not a colored light, so you can make it dimmer or brighter or whatever. But at least you know, once again, from the device menu, whether the light is on or off, and you can turn it on or off without any problem. Now, it does have the third tab at the bottom. If I
selected controls,
go to the bottom.
Selected routines, history tab.
That's history.
Selected history tab.
And
selected his filter all button. Navigate up, but more options. Activity all button. Filter all today. 2:34 p.m. Power on.
So it actually does tell you
159 power off
when you turn off and on the light.
Navigate up button. Smartphone SL20.
And there is a way to set the a time. So like if you want the light to turn off at 7 a.m. and turn back on at 7 p.m. you can set that. You can also have the light turn on for 10 minutes and go off, you know. So you can set it for, a timer. And that's pretty much all I'm going to demonstrate with that light. Okay, now for the fun stuff. The Samsung SmartThings app will allow you to control Samsung TVs. And it works pretty well, however, first of all, you have to turn on their voice guide to be able to work with it. And I have not found a way to do that with this app as of yet. You can use the remote, and some remotes allow you to hold down the mute button. Just hold and press it down and the accessibility will turn on. But this TV did not support that, so I had to have, as we call it, sighted assistance to get that done. So here we go.
TV, Samsung Bedroom, 1110 CBS News latest headlines.
So
double tap to view details.
When you go to the TV in the devices tab on the SmartThings app, it actually does tell you what channel the TV is on. So if you have little ones and you worry about them up at night, you'll know what they're watching. And that's kind of cool. So let's go explore this thing.
TV, Samsung Bedroom, 1100 TV, SmartThings, TV, Samsung Bedroom.
Now, the TV is on, and there's one oddity with this. You cannot turn on the TV with the iOS app. You can with the Android app, so I don't know what what the problem is there. But anyway, I'm going to unmute this TV.
Color, button, power, color, channel down, button, volume down, channel, header, volume, header, guide, button, mute, button, mute, button.
There we go. And we have TV. So you can go to channel up, channel down, sources, which will, you know, give you all your Netflix and everything. So this one is a Samsung Smart TV, allowing you to when you first sign up with it, you automatically get Samsung TV, which literally has thousands of channels.
Channel up button.
So we're doing CBS News right now. We'll go to channel up.
Channel up button.
1112 ABC News Live, ABC News Live, 2:30 p.m. to 3 p.m.
It will tell you what's on, and it will tell you, you know, when things end. So you'll know when the next show comes on.
News Live, 11 minutes left. TV.
Yeah, it's 11 minutes left in that show. So,
mute button, guide button.
Time's up.
Volume, header, channel, header.
You can change the volume.
Down. Color, power, button, return, button, smart hub, button, number pad, switch.
So it does have a number pad for the menus at the bottom, and you can actually move up and down the menus. I will show you that with the guide.
Smart hub, reach, power, color, channel down, volume down, channel, volume, guide, button. Guide, button.
Program guide filtered by all 1112 ABC News Live. ABC News Live, 2:30 p.m. to 3 p.m. on now ABC News Live, 10 minutes left. Document web.
Next click. Four direction touchpad image. Image. Left. Button. Swipe to navigate and tap to select. Right. Button. Down. Button. Button.
1 of 4. Document work. Next please. Document work.
Now with only 39.
Down.
11:14 NBC News. Now NBC News. Daily with Kate Snow and Sinhola Samuel 2 p.m. to 3. Document work. Next please. Document work.
To the border. Shin-
Down.
Shin-
button.
Now ABC News Live.
In July.
Document work.
Comes his new poll.
And that is a really, really brief demo of what the TV can do. If you have a Samsung TV, I would really recommend you check this out. It's pretty friendly. It's a little bit cumbersome. You can use Explorer by touch to find some of the buttons. And I'm not sure about presets or Netflix or how any of those work. Maybe that will be a future demonstration.
All right, very cool. Thanks, Wes. Great demo. What a neat things there in the SmartThings app for Samsung devices. Okay, Julie, if you can unmute everyone, we are going to open it up, see if anybody has questions for Wes in the SmartThings app. No, it's smarter than me. I'm not sure it's smarter than Wes.
This is Dan with a question.
Go ahead.
This is for Wes. What about audio description with the Samsung TV and the app? You didn't cover that. Can you turn on audio description with the app?
You know, it didn't have it in the app. It had closed captioning. I'll have to double check and see if you can do that. You might have to do that with the remote. I'll have to get back with you on that one.
Okay, thanks.
This is Pete.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Wes. Good demo there, guy. I'm at the very end there where you went through the, I think you went through the touchpad, the numpad, you said?
Right.
What were you doing there? Because I didn't hear a lot of clicks on your phone, but it did sound like channels were changing and things were happening on the TV. What were you?
Yeah,
what were you
I
doing?
Don't know. I don't know why it wasn't clicking. I was using the down arrow on the iPad. I mean iPhone app. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I didn't click the down arrow, but yeah, it went from channel to channel.
Is that where you were doing Explore by Touch, and you were just sliding your finger around? Yeah.
Yeah, and so the interesting thing about that, so you could hopefully hear the difference between the voiceover and the TV itself.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Thanks.
This is Carla for Wes.
Hi.
Hi. I have two Samsung TVs, one which is an older one than the other. I was just wondering, do you know what series, Samsung series of TVs the app will work with?
No, I don't. We have one Samsung TV that's old, too old to work.
Okay.
How old is your TVs, Carla?
The oldest one, I think, is a 2017 model.
Oh. It might work. Yeah, I think the bigger one we have is a little bit older than that. But if you download the SmartThings app, on the iOS App Store, how you do it is there's a device, and when you go to that, you'll have to, for the TVs, you put your phone near the TV and it will detect it with, if the TV has Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, it'll detect it.
Oh,
if there's
okay.
a QR code on it, you can do it that way.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. I'll give that a shot. Thanks.
Misty?
Hi, Misty.
Hi. I had a question about the microwave. Do you have to have the Hamilton talking microwave for it to work?
No, that's not a Hamilton. It's a Samsung.
A Samsung microwave?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, the stove also works with it. If you can go back to 2002, I did that the whole demo of the appliances, the microwave works with it, and now they've VoiceOver works with presets now, so you can actually have a few presets. Like if you do a heavy wash all the time, you can tell it heavy wash, and it'll take, you know, you don't have to go through each setting. So yeah, it's pretty accessible. And if they break accessibility, they're usually quick to fix it, like in a week.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep. All right, we've got time for one more question for Wes.
This is Intisar.
Hi.
Hi. I wanted to comment. There was somebody asked about if you can turn the audio description on, and you said you just saw the closed caption. Because I think probably you can. The reason is because not all programming, it has audio description on it. So you saw just the closed caption, maybe because that wasn't, because I know on my TV, it doesn't always show, sometimes just the closed caption and in the language, and sometimes will show both when the program does have audio description.
Right. I'll tell you what, I'll see if I can figure it out during Herbie's presentation when I'm muted.
Okay.
And then I can have more information on that. Yeah, because I use audio description for everything too, but I just didn't try it on the bedroom one.
And you mentioned, so this app, I could definitely, like, I have an iPhone, I can go to the Apple Store and the App Store and upload it, correct?
Yeah, it's the SmartThings app, and it's by Samsung.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
All right. Very good. Thank you, Wes. Great demo as usual. Appreciate you doing that. And yeah, be sure to check that out. Anybody that's got smart Samsung devices, have some voiceover control of some of those. All right. We're going to move along. While we got everybody unmuted, just wanted to give those people that did not get a chance to introduce themselves during the first round to do so now. If you'll just share your name, where you're connecting from. And we had an icebreaker that was asking, what is your favorite morning beverage? Coffee, tea, something else?
Gary from Arlington Heights. And my favorite beverage, if I can get it, is a chai latte iced tea with almond milk.
All right. Well, that's the first one we had of those. And that's one of our birthday girls of the month. We were celebrating your birthday without you here, Terry, earlier.
Oh, okay.
Anybody else?
This is Carla from the UK.
And I can guess what your favorite beverage is.
Oh, it's not tea. It's coffee.
I was going to say coffee.
Oh, well, there you go.
This is Pete.
Go ahead, Pete.
I'm from Jacksonville, Florida, and I like my son does fresh ground coffee, brewed coffee, black every morning. Yeah. I'm spoiled.
Hey, this is Wes. Really quick, I have an answer. So the show has to support it, but it's in the settings under accessibility, audio description is. So the problem is it wasn't on a show that supported it in the demo.
Very cool. Okay. So you can control audio description with the app. Very good. Okay. Continue on with introductions. Anybody that didn't get to chime in the first round?
This is Sri from India.
Go ahead, Sri.
And water.
In India. He's a water drinker. Yep. I can attest to that.
Yeah, this is Brian from Coffee Town.
All right. Where's Coffee Town, Brian?
It's from Chicago. Water.
All right, another water. Wow.
They're invading.
Anybody else? Okay. Well, so glad to have everybody with us on this afternoon, Saturday, the 26th or 28th, I guess it is. Let's see. I'm going to try to give away an Apple gift card. We've got a $25 Apple gift card. And if you were here listening to some of the Apple news and rumors, question from one of the items that I mentioned, there was a home accessory device rumored to be coming out. Mark Gurman from Bloomberg, I finally remembered what rag he writes for. Well, I guess it's electronic now, but Bloomberg's Mark Gurman talked about a squarish kind of iPod combination, iPad, HomePod, and Apple TV. So my question is, there were two types of devices that are supported or supposedly going to be supported by this. So say your name. If you are a facilitator or mentor with iBug, you're ineligible. Wow, nobody was listening to the news. All right, if you can tell me one of the types of devices.
Robert. Apple TV.
Not quite. The device itself is kind of a substitute for the Apple TV. But there's devices that are managed by a certain type of system, or two types of systems, actually. One of them is actually Google-based. Okay, looks like I'm going to get to keep my gift card. That was the HomeKit, Apple's HomeKit devices, and the Matter devices, or the devices that's going to be controlled by this supposedly home accessory controller. So we'll see if that comes to fruition, but seems like the rumors are getting pretty strong for it. There's always been rumors for the last several years about something like this coming out, so maybe it's coming true. All right. You know what? I hate to hang on to this gift card. It's like burning a hole in my electronic wallet. Let me think of another question. Okay. I mentioned Best Buy is got a good deal on the iPad Pros. Which chip was in that iPad Pro?
This is Ted.
Ted.
M2.
The M2. You are absolutely correct, Ted.
Hey.
Get the door prize, $25 gift card.
Thank you.
I think
we know where
you. Way to go. Yes, we know where you live, so you will be getting an email for an e-gift card, $25 Apple gift card. All right, way to go, Ted. All right, let's see. Julie, if you can put everybody back on mute.
Okay.
We're going to have Kirby step to the plate. He's been on deck patiently waiting. Okay, I think we got him. All right, Herbie, if you can unmute and come back in.
All right. Good afternoon, everyone, or whenever you're listening to this, whatever time of day it is on the podcast. So let's talk about Apple's things that they've released. Now, the article that I have starts with the iPhone 16. I'm going to circle back to that because I know that's probably what, you know, it's going to generate the most interest, and so I don't want, but I want to make sure you don't fall asleep for the other things that I'm going to talk about too.
Herbie, sorry, I have to do one thing before you get going too strongly there. I know you're eager to go, but for those of you that did not happen to watch the actual Apple event, they had a pretty cool intro video, audio described video. It's about a little under 4 minutes, I think. So I want to play that right now as an intro for Herbie.
In a bedroom, a woman with one arm ties her shoe. She double taps her thumb and index finger to play a song on her Apple Watch. At home, an older man answers a FaceTime call from a woman and a child. In an empty church room, a man wearing an Apple Watch puts a chair on a dolly. A man works out in his living room. A tall Apple Watch user arrives home. At a dinner table, a bearded man speaks American Sign Language. Now, a florist wearing AirPods Pro arranges flowers. The tall Apple Watch user slides into a room. In the church, the man dances with the dolly. Bridge, a young woman using a motorized wheelchair shimmies. In a parked car, a man with glasses and a woman dance. The man in his living room dances to an Apple Fitness Plus video. The woman with one arm grooves in front of a mirror. The older man dances with a child on FaceTime. The tall Apple Watch user spins with a cardboard moving box. In a subway station, a woman in scrubs wears AirPods and snaps. The woman in front of the mirror dances in a circle. Titles: Melissa Shapiro uses assistive touch on Apple Watch to make life more accessible. The florist adjusts an arrangement. Titles: Susan Putnam used AirPods Pro to call 911 after an injury left her immobile. The young woman using the wheelchair sways to the beat. Titles: Jocelyn Mondragon used dictation on iPhone to help her graduate college. The man in the car moves to the music. Titles: Colton Holman was safely rescued after crash detection on Apple Watch triggered 911. Melissa checks her Apple Watch and closes an exercise ring. The montage of the Apple product users continues. They dance, groove, and vibe out alone and with family and friends. The older man continues dancing while on a FaceTime call. Titles: Tony Johnson uses FaceTime to see his grandkids every week. The bearded man joyfully dances at the dinner table. Titles: Tyson Haley uses live captions on iPhone to communicate with his family. At home, the tall man boogies. Titles: Stephen Luemba uses the ECG app on Apple Watch to check his heart after surgery. The man in the church pumps his shoulders as he pushes the dolly. Titles: Maurice Wright received critical care after his Apple Watch alerted him of AFib. The woman in scrubs dances on a subway platform. Titles: Kendra Crawford Blue listens to music on AirPods Pro for motivation between shifts. The person working out pauses and checks his Apple Watch. Titles: Noel Cavanaugh used Apple Fitness Plus to get into the best shape of his life. Designed to make every day something to celebrate. Tyson and his family embrace. Jocelyn shimmies and smiles as she crosses the bridge. Now, we rise into a blue sky speckled by clouds. We lower to Cupertino. The Santa Cruz Mountains tower in the distance. We descend to Apple Park, swoop through the large glass windows of the atrium, and fly across a grassy meadow. Lush trees and flora line the open field and surrounding trails. Tim Cook stands before the rainbow stage.
Okay. Yeah, I just thought that was pretty cool that some of you may have not heard that. Got a chance to listen to that, but at the introduction of the Apple event on September 9th, showing people and doing everyday things, and included a number of people with disabilities. It wasn't, you know, wasn't about disabilities or accessibility per se. So that was, thought it was really inclusive and pretty cool for them to do that. And even though they swooped down to have Tim Cook, we are swooping down to have Herbie Allen do our presentation.
All right. Well, on the pecking order of things, I am no Tim Cook. You're not going to see me on the Tonight Show handing Jimmy Fallon his Apple phone. Though at one time we did have an Apple, an iBug member who did work at an Apple store and could have, you know, maybe handed Michael McCullough his phone. And the iBug member we had as an Apple employee was none other than Tim Rezaid. So, you know, anyway, but I digress. So, as I said, to ensure that you're going to stay awake, I'm going to talk about the iPhone last. So, let's start with the Apple Watch. There are two Apple Watches released, the Apple Watch Series 10 and the Apple Watch Series Pro 2. Let's start with the Apple Watch Series 10. It is their thinnest design yet, and they've remade it. It's now 46 millimeters in length for the larger model and 42 for the smaller model. And if you've never gotten the Apple Watch before, it's a great fitness tracking little device, and it can do many things. But the new thing that they're introducing for it this year is sleep apnea detection. And so now it can actually detect it, you know, on a basic level, at least, if you have sleep apnea. You know, I was thinking about this. Somebody posted on Facebook once, what do you expect to see gone by 2030? And At the time, I thought about something else completely non-technological related. But then I got to listening to the Apple event and all the things they were talking about with the Apple Watch and what it can do now, and then the AirPods, which we'll talk about too a little bit later on. And what got me thinking is what might be gone by 2030 is the hospital. Or, you know, it might be slightly diminished because we'll have all these wearables that can do the medical detecting for us. Anyway, enough of that wild tangent. So, and the watch can charge even faster than ever, so that is definitely impressive, and that is the Apple Watch Series 10. Apple Watch Ultra 2, I think I said Pro 2 earlier, Apple Watch Ultra 2, the ultimate in sports and adventure watch, and a new black titanium case. And it has the most accurate GPS in a sports watch. And it has connectivity features for everyday health and whatnot. The thing to keep in mind, of course, the Apple Watch 2 Ultra is it is designed, deemed to work on the LTE. So is the Apple Watch Series 10 if you get the more expensive model. But let's see. Did they talk about any new features that it gets? So, you do have a customizable action button on the Apple Watch Ultra. Extended battery life. Up to 36 hours of battery life on the Ultra 2, so that's pretty impressive there. And that's with normal use. And if you're in low power mode, you can get up to 72 hours. So that's basically a 3 days hike in low power mode you could do and still have your watch working. And if you're doing an outdoor workout, though, I guess a hike wouldn't be a good idea because that would just be 17 hours. So, and yeah, so and of course in conjunction with Apple Map, it has a dual position GPS. And let's see, anything else exciting about the Apple Watch Ultra? I'm not sure what to go into the advertisement on what the Apple Watch Ultra 2 does. I don't know how all that compares to the Ultra 1, so I'm not going to go into all that. But just know that that was one of the features announced with the Apple event. AirPods 4. So these are, there's two different types of AirPods, the AirPods and the AirPods Pro. These are your standard AirPods, so they do not have the silicone tip. These are the flat ones. But they've now introduced some cool features to the AirPods Pro that were AirPods rather that they did not have before, including noise canceling, active listening, and updated fit for all-day comfort. And we talked more in depth about that last Monday on the Apple iToy segment, so you'll want to refer to that for all the details on that. That is, Brad gave us a good demo of that. One of the features that Apple has touted with its new AirPods is the ability to be able to use your head to shake yes or no to answer the phone. And so far, everybody that has brought that feature up to me has told me that it does not work. So, let's see. Anything else exciting? Personalized spatial audio with dynamic head tracking. And so you can get immersive sound and all that. It has the Apple H2 chip, but I think so did the 3. And so much more. But the big key, like you said, of the AirPods 4 is the active noise cancellation and whatnot. AirPods Pro 2. There's not a new AirPods Pro 2, but there's going to be a software update later this fall. And remember what I said earlier about the hospital becoming obsolete? Okay, that's probably that's we're so far away from that. But one of the things that's going to be interesting with the AirPods Pro 2 now is they can actually do an onboard hearing test. It takes about 5 minutes. And they can also act as a basic form of hearing aids for mild to moderate hearing loss. And the AirPods Pro 2, they're the ones, of course, like I said, with the customizable silicone tips. And AirPods Max, those are the over-ear AirPods. The only claim to fame they have is they are now going to be USB-C instead of Lightning. So the advantage might be if you've upgraded your iPhone, getting them would mean if you have a 15 Pro now or 15 or above, now that you don't have to worry about two separate charging cords, you only have to worry about one. So that's it for the AirPods. And now let's talk about the iPhone 16 and the iPhone 16 Pro. So these, of course, are the biggins. So, of course, the big claim to fame with the Apple 16 is going to be Apple Intelligence. Tim Cook already told us a lot about how that's going to start off in the next month with it summarizing your email. So, and more is going to come out as time goes on, including AI introduced to Siri, which will hopefully make it smarter. And there's going to be better camera controls. And let's see, what else does the iPhone 16 have? Let's see. So you'll have new tools to help you write, focus, and communicate. So there will be writing tools to help proofread your texts. And that's not going to be just for text messages, but that's going to be third-party apps as well. And you'll be able to record in Notes and have it generate audio transcripts. So that's going to be pretty cool. You'll be able to prioritize messages in Mail. And iPhone 15 users will get some of these Apple Intelligence features, but of course not all of them. I mentioned about better the camera control. I'm not going to go into much of that because I don't know how all that's going to work with VoiceOver, so that's a whole new thing altogether. But better camera controls, like I said. Ultra-wide camera. And it'll be able to focus on the little things. Now it'll also have spatial capture. So spatial capture. So what that means for VoiceOver users, I have no idea at this point if it'll improve anything like with OCR or anything like that. But that'll be cool if it does. iPhone 16 is going to have some new audio mix features, including the ability to record and watch videos that you record in surround sound. So that's going to be cool. And what it'll do is you'll be able to isolate things, like it just capture the people of the voices that you want. And it'll make it sound like you're recording in a professional studio. And with cinematic sound, you'll be able to format your videos kind of like you would for the movies. And there's the iPhone 16, of course, and the iPhone 16 Pro and Pro Max. And the big things to know about them is, of course, the Pro and the Pro Max is all the iPhones will have better battery life. And I'm forgetting the numbers off the top of my head, but Jonathan Mosen did a recap event of the Apple event, and they talk about the battery life in the phones. And, you know, I don't remember the numbers. It's going to be pretty impressive, though. Another key feature of the iPhone 16 Pro is it's going to have a studio-quality microphone. So that'll be interesting to see how that works out. Let's see. Can I find out to tell you anything related to the iPhone 16 Pro? Let's see. Oh, one thing you'll get now with the 16 Pro, at least, is multi-tracking with voice memos. So what this means is that you can record, like, say for if you're a musician and you have a karaoke track that you import and you want to record your voice over it, you'll be able to do so. And you won't have to wear headphones if you don't want to. So that's going to be another feature coming to the iPhone. And with that, it's pretty much, that's all the small recap of the features, the things that were released and announced in the iPhone event. So again, you've got the Apple Watch Series 10, you've got the Apple Watch Ultra 2, you've got the AirPods 4, software updates coming to AirPods Pro 2, and you've got the iPhone 16 and the iPhone 16 Pro. There was nothing announced about iPads or anything like that. Oh yes, and USB-C coming to the AirPods Max. So, with that, what I'm going to do here. Okay. Michael's right. It does mute you now. Okay, that's different. Anyway, I have now given everybody permission to unmute if you want to ask any questions.
So much there. I had one question really for everybody. Anybody planning to buy any of the new devices, the iPhone?
This is Herbie.
Yeah, go ahead, Herbie.
I'm really thinking about, though I'm going to read your 10 reasons and see if that changes my decision. I'm definitely interested in upgrading to the iPhone 16 Pro this year. I currently have the 13, and the 14 and the 15 didn't really excite me that much. USB-C is cool and all that, but I'm really curious with some of the audio things for the iPhone 16 Pro and the improved battery life.
Yeah, okay. Anybody else finding the good iPhones or?
I think Paul had a question.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, excuse me. Yeah, do all of the 16s have better battery life comparatively?
This is Herbie. Compared to the older iPhones, yes. But the 16 Plus is going to have a better battery life than the 16. The 16 Pro is going to have a better battery life than both of those, and the 16 Pro Max is going to give you the best battery life possible.
Okay, now we know we need to know the 10 reasons why to wait. So, and I'm not on Facebook.
All right, anybody else?
This is Terry.
All right, Terry, then Roy.
Yes, I'm not on Facebook either, so I don't know if I'll ever know what those 10 reasons are. But anyway, it is a curious thing. I'm probably going to upgrade my phone, but I don't know if I'll upgrade to the 16 or not. If I do anything, I might upgrade my watch. I have a series 6 and a Series 8 that I'm using right now. But did I hear something in the new series? Is it the Series 10 watch? Is that the new one?
Yes.
Something about a speaker in the watch?
Oh, yes. I'm so glad you reminded me about that. And I'm actually thinking about upgrading my watch for this too. One of the things that you'll be able to now do with the Apple Watch Series 10 is actually play through things directly through the watch. So right now, for instance, you do have apps like Audible and whatnot, but you have to have some type of Bluetooth headphones paired with it to be able to use your watch. But with the Apple Watch Series 10, you'll be able to now play like your Audible books through the speaker itself, the watch speaker itself. And all I can say for those of you that are not on Facebook, get on there and then go to facebook.com/group/iBugToday and join the group. And there you go. And then you'll know the top 10 reasons why you should wait until iOS 17. And you never know what other interesting things you'll discover with Facebook along the way.
This is John.
Roy first and then John.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Herbie. The Apple Watch, you know, on my phone, the health app will count my steps per day. If I left my phone at home, can the Apple Watch do that for me?
Okay, that's getting into the specifics of the Apple Watch, not so much talking about what's been released. So I want to say I think it can. Just know that if you're going to leave your watch, take your watch with you, by the way, you might want the cellular version and not just the Wi-Fi version. But I'd encourage you to come back Monday night, and that would be a great place to really talk more in depth about the specifics of the Apple Watch. And I want to just focus on questions related to the new products today.
Fair enough.
We'll go into the more specific. That's what our Monday night call is for. So
this is Roy again.
Yep.
Before I back out, what about this falling stuff? Have they improved that with this new version, or is it still?
You mean the fall detection?
Yeah.
I haven't heard anything about that, but I will tell you from my own personal experiences, the fall detection does work. I took a tumble off of a curb several months ago, and I was all right, but the fall detection immediately went off on my watch and said, "We've detected a fall. Are you okay?" And I'm running a Series 8. So it seems like it works pretty well already, but I don't know if it's significantly improved or not with the Series 10. I couldn't tell you.
Okay, I'll come back Monday night with some more. Thanks.
But it wouldn't surprise me if they've made some kind of like finite adjustments or whatever.
Appreciate it.
All right, John.
Yeah, I was. My apologies. I was trying to multitask, so I didn't get to hear everything in detail. I was wondering if you had already mentioned the 80% charging in 30 minutes for the Series 10 Apple Watch.
I didn't get into the specifics, but yeah, I just mentioned that it has faster charging, but that does sound exciting that you can do that inside 30 minutes, and another reason to consider upgrading the watch. Another reason why I'm interested in upgrading the watch too is because I do try to use the on-screen keyboard sometimes, and will that 1 inch of extra or millimeter of extra real estate make a significant difference? Probably not, but hey, you know.
This is Claudette.
Yes.
I have never had an Apple Watch, and I've been considering it. So now that they've upgraded and changed, which would you recommend I get first?
I would recommend the Apple Watch. Well, let me ask you this. Are you like an extreme sports person or anything like that?
Not anymore, but you know, I do like to go out and walk. I definitely listen to Audible books, and it would certainly be great not to always have to have my phone with me when I want to listen to a book.
So then you are going to want the Apple Watch Series 10. Again, if you don't want to take your phone with you, I recommend getting the cellular model because that way it'll be able to fully function as a phone when you're not away from your phone. But now if you're like, say, Michael McCullough and you go hiking the trails of Machu Picchu, for instance, then I would recommend, you know, the Apple Watch Ultra Series instead. For just general walking, I think just the Apple Watch Series 10 would be sufficient.
Okay, no, I'm not going to do Machu Picchu yet, but maybe next.
Yeah. Okay, well, in that case, then you might want to, if you're going to do that, or maybe even the Ski for Light, then, then maybe take a closer look at the Apple Watch Ultra 2, because it is designed, you know, more for more like rugged outdoor type things like that. So,
okay.
But you know.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Okay. Who's next?
This is Sheree.
Yes.
Have you talked about any of the cost on these?
I don't, just because I don't have them in front of me. But I will promise you all this much: they are very expensive. So, but you can go to the Apple Store app and look at the products, and that'll tell you the cost. The iPhone, I know, starts at around $900. Also, before this question comes up, I'm just going to go ahead and address it now. There has been nothing said about the next SE model of phones. So there's plenty going around the rumor mill, of course, but we don't have anything confirmed yet. So just thought I'd mention that too. But the Pro Max is going to be the most expensive. Same with the Apple Watch Ultra 2. That's going to be the most expensive in the Apple Watch lineup. AirPods Max are going to be the most expensive AirPods, but they've also had the least amount of change. And yeah. All right, who else?
Pat.
Good job today.
Oh, thank you.
And great summary. Thank you. You're welcome.
I will tell you something interesting that, I was talking to somebody in Clubhouse yesterday that had an iPhone 16, and they were using it unplugged, like, so they weren't using any headphones or anything like that. And the one thing we noticed is, like, we did not hear their voiceover even, like, bleed through at all. Like, so it seems like they really... And that's just from listening to somebody on Clubhouse. So it does sound like they really have made some improvements to the way the microphones work. So that is... I find that definitely exciting, so... Okay, who else?
This is Shree.
Yes, Shree.
I do have a question for Wes regarding the Samsung.
Well, let's make sure we're done with this first, and then I'll let Michael decide how that he'll handle that.
Okay.
So last call for questions on this topic. All right. Oh, was somebody trying to say something?
Any questions on the Apple event? Any of the hardware that was introduced? And just to remind everybody, the iBug Cafe coming up October 13th will go in detail looking at the iOS 18, the new software. So we're just sticking with the hardware today.
I'm not hearing any, so I yield my time. Back to the chair.
All right. Thank you, Herbie. Yeah, great overview of the Apple event and the hardware that was introduced there. So I guess we got a few minutes left here. Why don't we, I think Shree had a question for Wes. Wes, you still around?
I am. Let's do it.
Go ahead, Shree, come back in.
So Wes, does the Samsung, does it support any kind of voice activation stuff? And second is, how do I get the QR code to show up on the TV?
The TVs don't use the QR codes. The TVs, it's usually proximity. So, and I don't know if it uses a Bluetooth side channel or what, but I had to be pretty close for it to see it. I had to be standing right in front of it.
So, so we recently bought some Samsung TVs. So if I just turn it on, just bring the phone next to it, it should decide which TV this is.
Yeah, you have to be in the app, and you have to add a new device, and then it will. Here, I can. Can you hear voiceover?
Yeah.
Let me.
It's kind of fast.
Yeah. There we go.
Smart things. Double tap to open. Smart things. Location information button.
So, on the either the device or favorites tab, there is an add.
Phone one button. Add button.
And you double tap the add button.
Add. Add device button. Create camera group button. Dismiss context menu. Dismiss context. Create camera. Add device. Add device button. Create camera group.
Oh, I think I have to do it from the device.
Add device.
There's add device.
Add device. Add device button. Add device button. Scan QR code button. Scan nearby button.
So you'd go to scan nearby.
Devices. Empty list. Empty list. Searching for device. In progress. Add device.
It didn't find any.
In progress. Searching for devices. Empty list.
But yeah, that's what you would do. So it's just two steps. It's just from either the device tab or the favorites tab. You just go to the add device and then scan nearby.
Searching for device in progress. Add device. Add device.
And does any of the Samsung support like voice activation to run on some of the commands?
Now it's supposed to work. Yeah, some TVs have the voice activation. I don't think any of ours do. But yeah, you should be able to talk to the TV or talk to a Amazon device and be able to turn on and off the TV. I haven't tried that. But I don't know if that's a part of SmartThings or not.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, and you can always get with me sometime, and we can try and figure out some things.
Sounds good. Thanks.
Yeah. All right.
Okay. Any other questions about the topics from today? Either the Samsung Smart Things app or any of the hardware introduced at a Apple event. I heard Carla mention earlier that her oldest television was from 2017. And I was going to say, I still have a Sony that, well, it's the only TV I have, 56-inch Sony that I bought in 2004. So I'm pretty sure there's no smart.
Whoa.
As far as I can tell, it sounds good. I can't speak for the picture. I'm not sure. But, yeah, it sounds still kicking. So anybody, well, if there's no questions about any of the topics, we'll kind of turn this into a mini buzz for the next 15 minutes. Go back to Roy. I think Roy had some questions about the Apple Watch, fall detection, and something else, Roy, if you're still there. Let's see if we can answer those. Maybe we got the right people here. Maybe not. We'll see.
I think he left.
Oh, we lost Roy. Okay. He'll come back Monday night. Anybody else have just general iOS issues, questions they're having?
This is Sri.
Go ahead.
Michael, can you give us a teaser on your thing that you're going to put in Facebook? Can you give like one that you thought was the most reason that you thought was why you right. might want to wait?
Well, it's already out there. And actually, a good thing. I'm glad you brought that up. If anybody's not on Facebook, you can go to macrumors.com, macrumors.com, and do a search for 10 reasons to wait for the iPhone 17. Shoot, I'm trying to remember now. Let's see if I can quickly pull them up here. I know I had it somewhere. Oh, the 17, I think they were going to have a thinner. I think they were going to call it the 17 Air.
Yeah.
It was going to be a pro. I don't know if it's one of the pros or just a totally new model, but I was kind of intrigued by that
thinner. I think it's supposed to be for the Plus.
Oh, okay. But it was kind of in between, I can't remember, 6.5 inch or something like that, in between the smallest and biggest pros. What else did they talk about?
This is free.
I think they had improved Wi-Fi, whatever the next Wi-Fi level is. What are we're on right now? Wi-Fi 5 or 6? I can't remember. I think it was
Wi-Fi 6. Wi-Fi 6.
Yeah, I think they were going to 7.0 on this new device. And if I'm not mistaken, they talked about using their own, they've developed now to replace the network, whatever you call that thing, to connect the networks.
The Wi-Fi?
For cellular.
Oh, cellular.
Connection. They used to, always have a third party do that. Talking about the selfie camera, probably most people aren't worried about that one, but
the 5G.
Yeah, but it was the actual hardware. I can't remember what it's called, but anyway, the selfie camera was going to 24 megapixels. I think the current one's like 12 on the Pro Max and the 16s. There were a number of different things like that. So I think the display itself was like twice as hard as whatever new kind of glass they're using now. So a lot more scratch resistant and also an anti-reflection property to it. And of course, they always say better battery life. I think it was going to bump the memory up too. What's in the current one? Like 8 gigs of RAM, maybe And I think this one's going, 17 is going to 12. So it looked like quite a bit of things going on there. And of course, the processor bump up to the A19, even better for AI. Anyway, if you're, I mean, if you, you know, if you have an older device, then the 16 is a great upgrade. So don't let that hold you back. And it's also going to work with, you know, all the current Apple Intelligence features that they're planning over the next year. All right. Any other questions?
This is Paul.
Hey, Paul.
This is kind of an overlap with a Macintosh session, I suppose. But did I hear that whatever new current software with the Macs, you can run your Apple apps from your phone on the computers?
Mirroring, yes. That's supposed to be one of the new features. Although I heard somebody talking about it, that they're, that the voiceover may not be coming through. They've got a bug in it right now, but hopefully with the new 18.1 and whatever Sequoia.1 they're on. What are they on? 11 or 12? I don't remember. On the Mac OS. Kirby may know what's on the Sequoia, but anyway. I mean, that is a feature that's supposed to be there to be able to mirror your iPhone on the Mac and use it using your touchpad on a MacBook or you've got a display, a little touchpad display, then you can utilize it. Maybe even, I guess, integrates with the keyboard if you want to need to type anything on your iPhone. All right. Any other questions? No inquisitive minds out there. Well, we may just have to call it a day.
Thank you.
I can let you listen to my playlist that was during the intro. Going to do that.
Michael, this is Shree.
Yeah, Shree.
I missed the beginning part of your thing today. Did they announce, did you make any information on, or did you state anything about the sales of the iPhones, how well they're doing this year?
You know, I haven't heard anything about that. I don't know. Has anybody else heard iPhone sales, what compared to other years in the first week or two now? It's been on sale.
I'm not hearing any big hypes this year.
Yeah, it's been fairly quiet. I was expecting it to be a few sales, especially with the AI stuff. So I guess it remains to be seen.
I would say that's probably one of the reasons that I'm holding back is the AI is not going to be here till next year.
Yeah, the full set of features that they've talked about. I mean, they'll roll them out over the coming year. So.
Got my RTA Mark